It's Russia versus China. Well, one bronze medal already decided. It took a long time deep into golden score time for that to occur. Will this be the same? Perhaps to go on the attack in the blue for China. Kuzmitina of Russia wearing the white colours. She'll be flying no white flags, though. She won't sit back. She won't rely on counter-attack only. She has plenty of moves of her own.
Yeah, it's just got to be a bit careful of the drop shoulder throw there of Ma. It's left against left. And it's Kuzmitina that sets it up. Straight away, she opens up the account. Both going to be looking for the same technique. And like I say, it's going to be left to left. Left to left means that the sleeve presents itself. Just depends on who can get the hand on first to initiate the throw.
So Ma defeated the hometown hero, Miranda of Brazil, in the quarterfinals to make her way into the semis, but then was defeated by the young Italian, Giffrida. Hence in this bronze medal bout against Kuzmitina, who came through the repercharge system. She was defeated by Nakamura of Japan in her quarterfinal. And Nakamura, of course, already with a bronze medal in the earlier bout. So good form lines for both these ladies, of course. That's why they're so deep into a competition, a battle for bronze. And it is a real battle at the moment. Kuzmitina is happy to get up, reset, and try to attack. And in fact, despite looking like that Ma was the aggressor there, the Shido penalty against her.
Yeah, it's all depends on the quality of the attack. And the quality of the attacks from Kuzmitina, much better. Looking for the Ippon all the time. Arm round the waist that time, big hips across. And Ma, I think, has got to be a little bit careful here. She's going to fall behind. So another warning for the Chinese coach this time. All shouting while they're actually fighting. Can't do that. You have to wait till there's a break in the action, then you can shout. A little bit like the tennis rule.
Easy to say, hard to do.
Well, there's the turnover again. Yeah, exactly. Turnover from Kuzmitina. She does it a lot and then turns it into the hold down. Can she tie up the top half? She has got the top half. And now she's going to push her onto her back here. Mara's in trouble here. Can she get the hold down? Yes, she does. I'll say, Komi, that means the hold is being held, and she just needs to hold her there now for 20 seconds.
So 10 seconds is a score, 15 upgrades that score. And if we get all the way to 20, it's all over. Can you get out of it when you're in this position? Not really. Not today.
No, it's all over. Kuzmitina gets the bronze medal. That was a brilliant performance from her. Really good, solid groundwork attacks. Ma was in trouble as soon as she went down to ground. As soon as she had the top half controlled, tied up, Kuzmitina took the leg out and it was game over.
Well played. The Russians there adding a bronze medal in the women's 52 kilogram division. It's been a successful competition in the first 2 days for the Russians. No doubt about that. For Ma on this occasion, it's not to be. So to now stand on the third step of the podium with a bronze medal. Natalia Kuzmitina from Russia. The second Olympic Games, the first medal.
Yeah, she did absolutely great judo. Good groundwork as well. The two times that she won crucial matches on the ground. Her follow through from standing down to ground, very, very important. Big smile on her face says it all.
27-year-old uni graduate is something to take back home.